Here we have a problem where we're going to feed a liquid mixture, methylene ethanol. We're going to lower the pressure and carry out this flash adiabatically. So we're going to end up with a vapor liquid mixture at 2 bar pressure. We want to know then what's the temperature where this happens, the effluent from this flash drum. What fraction of the liquid that we feed is turned into vapor? And then what are the compositions of the liquid and the vapor? We're going to need additional information, and so you should think about what that information is. Here are the values that I'm going to use. We need heat capacities for both liquid and vapor. We need heats of vaporization. And we need Antoine equations. And a couple of things that I'll point out in this solution that you need to keep in mind. Going to work in pressure bar, that's what given the problem statement. The Antoine equations I found, however, millimeters of mercury, so I'm going to have to correct for that. I'm also going to work in Kelvin, but the Antoine equation in centigrade, so I'll have to correct for that also in my final equations. Now I'm going to end up solving this numerically. I'm going to set up the equations and in separate screencasts show numerical solutions to the final values. But let's look at what a diagram represents for feeding methanol and ethanol. Ideal solution. These are very similar molecules. We're going to assume constant heat capacities, the values I've given. And then we'll assume these heats of vaporization are at 300 Kelvin. And we're going to use 300 Kelvin as our reference temperature. That's arbitrary, convenient value. 1 mole of feed, and so V is the moles of vapor, L is the moles of liquid. We have to have these two phases, liquid and vapor, in equilibrium. So we're going to need an energy balance. Now this Q is zero, no heat removed from the system. We're going to need energy balance, which is just total energy in equals total energy out. We're going to need mass balances. And the mass balances are that we're feeding 1 mole and it leaves either as vapor or liquid, so they have to add to 1. I'll use Z to represent the mole fraction of methanol. So Z of methanol is 0.30 times 1. That's the number of moles of methanol coming into the system. The number of moles of methanol leaving, or the mole fraction of the vapor phase, times the number of moles in the vapor phase. Mole fraction of methanol in the liquid phase, and the number of moles in the liquid phase. We could write another equation for ethanol, but it would be redundant with the total mass balance. And then the third thing we're going to need is vapor-liquid equilibrium. Because we have this mixture, the mole fractions are going to, in this case, be modeled by Raoult's law, because ideal solution. So we're going to say the mole fraction methanol in the liquid phase, saturation pressure methanol at the temperature, the T out temperature, mole fraction of the vapor phase, the pressure out, which is 2 bar. And then we have this same type equation for methanol. Couple more things that we need for this vapor liquid equilibrium. The mole fractions in the liquid phase must add to 1, and the mole fractions in the vapor phase must add to 1. And then we need the saturation pressures as a function of temperature. So the log, that's base 10, that's where given methanol saturation is in the form A minus B over T plus a constant. So A, B, and C are constants, and they're different for ethanol. So we have a corresponding equation for ethanol. Don't need to write that down. Keep in mind, temperature here is in degrees centigrade, pressure in millimeters of mercury. We're going to have to correct for that. The big thing that we need more information is this energy balance. So let's look at the terms. So we have energy coming in for methanol and ethanol. Energy in for methanol, I'm going to write that down. This is a total energy. So I have Z moles. Z is a mole fraction. Number of moles is 1. So Z times 1 is Zm. That's the mole fraction, and that's the number of moles of methanol. And they're coming in with some enthalpy. Well, what I'm going to do is pick my reference temperature and say enthalpy methanol at 300 plus heat capacity methanol in the liquid phase, the actual inlet temperature minus 300, working in Kelvin. But enthalpies are arbitrary, only differences are important. I'm going to set that equal to zero, and I'm going to do the same thing for the total ethanol in. Of course, that's Z of ethanol in the corresponding term, so I won't write all those down. And then we have the enthalpy of methanol in the liquid phase leaving the system. So that's the number of moles. So it's a mole fraction times the number of moles of liquid. That's the moles of methanol. And the same idea, enthalpy at 300 is my reference. So heat capacity, the temperature out now, minus 300. And likewise, and I won't write that down, we have the corresponding term for ethanol. And then the final thing we need is the enthalpy out in the vapor phase, mole fraction ethanol in the vapor phase times the moles of vapor. Now I need something different. I'm going to, again, the same reference, but I'm going to now vaporize that ethanol, the heat of vaporization per mole. I'm going to vaporize it at 300 Kelvin, and then I'm going to heat up the vapor. So this is for methanol. I'm going to heat up, use the heat capacity of the vapor, the T out minus 300. And then likewise, I have a corresponding term for ethanol, or heat to vaporization, heat capacity for ethanol. Now I have all the terms for the energy balance, mass balance, vapor liquid equilibrium, nonlinear equations with this saturation pressure temperature dependence. I'm going to solve these numerically. I'll show a couple different approaches in other screencasts. One is to use polymath. The other is to use a spreadsheet. What I'm going to show here are the final results I got from that solution. So here are the values. I've only reported them here to two significant figures, and in the other screencasts you can see the details of these calculations, see more significant figures.